Today I will talk about Duster, which proposes an alternative linear layer for raster. And this is joint work together with Gregor Leander. An open question in research is the minimal number of AND operations a cipher needs to still ensure security. And there are two different metrics. One is the AND depth. Therefore, you consider a cipher as a circuit and look at the longest path and count the number of AND gates there. So for example, in the right picture, we have AND depth of 3. And the other metric is the number of ANDs per bit. And for that, you count the total number of AND operations in the circuit and then divide by the block length. One cipher which performs very well in both metrics is the family of stream cipher raster. It has very low AND depth and number of ANDs per encrypted bit between 4 and 6. There are many applications where this AND count matters. One example is the fully homomorphic encryption scheme BGV. It comes with a large ciphertext expansion, and AND operations are much more expensive than XOR operations in this scheme. One scenario would be the following. You encrypt your data on your own PC symmetric to prevent the ciphertext expansion, just the key under which your data is encrypted has to be encrypted under FHE, but usually is your data much larger than the key. Then you send both to the server. The server first performs an FHE encryption on your data, but then to actually work on your data, the symmetric encryption has to be undone, and therefore it performs a symmetric decryption under FHE. And because AND operations are much more expensive in this scheme, raster would be a good choice in this scenario. Another application is, for example, multiparty computation or masking, which is important for side channel resistance. Let's start with the structure of raster. The initial state is the key, and one round consists of two parts. First, we have an affine mapping, and this is pseudo-randomly generated by an expandable output function, which takes as input a nonce and a block counter. And this XOF could be, for example, shake 256. And what is also important is that the generation of the affine layer is public. So the evaluation of the XOF does not count into the AND metric. And if we look at the previous client-server example, then if the server executes raster, it does not have to evaluate the XOF under FHE. The second part of one round is the nonlinear layer, the chi function, which is a generalization of the chi function of Ketchak. And note that this function has weak diffusion properties, so one output bit depends on only three input bits. And then in the AND, we have one final affine layer, and the key is XORed again to the state. Now we have a table of the different versions of raster. So we have 4 to 6 rounds, and that's also why we have AND depth between 4 and 6 because the Chi layer just consists of one AND operation per bit. Our motivation for Duster was that we were curious if we can create a design which follows a deterministic approach and does not need the XOF. First, because of security arguments, which do not longer rely on an XOF, and second, because of performance improvements. And if we want to get rid of the XOF, that also means that we have to design an alternative for this affine layer. And in Duster now, the affine layer is just determined by a counter. And that also means that we need to think about of a set of affine layers. Let's first have a look of what is not a good idea for this deterministic affine layer. So in this example, are all affine layers the identity? And we take a look at one qubit and which bits of the state are influenced by this qubit. So obviously, after the application of the first affine layer, nothing happens. Then after the first application of the Chi layer, we have 3 bits of the state involved. Then after the next affine layer, again, nothing happens. And then after the application of the next Chi layer, one more bit is involved. So that after a few rounds, in the end, there are still many bits of the state which do not depend on this qubit. The generalization of this threat are non-trivial subspace trails, and in the paper we showed that there exists no subspace trails over all rounds for all versions of Duster. And we decided to split the affine layer in 2 parts for Duster. So we have chosen this set of all as the composition of a variable bit permutation and a fixed L. And we showed in the paper a technique to prove the absence of subspace trails for a fixed L, and this is invariant over all bit permutations, and that's also one reason why we decided to split in these 2 parts. Now we focus on the bit permutation layer and start again with an example of what should not happen. We look at the beginning of the generation of a keystream block, and on the left side, in the first step, the key is permuted with P0, and in the second block the key is permuted with the bit permutation P1, which just differs in 2 transitions. So if the first 2 qubits are equal, the state after the bit permutation is also still equal. And since the bit permutation is the only variable part in one round, we have a 50% chance that the state is still in both blocks equal after one round. And that's something which should not happen, but especially it shouldn't happen for all rounds. And What we are looking for is the probability P that two bit permutations P0 and P1 map an X to the same value. And that's the same as the probability of a fixed point for the difference of these two bit permutations. And to compute this probability, we have to look at the number of cycles of the underlying permutation pi. And we showed that in lemma 1 in the paper. And you see that if you have a low number of cycles, which means that m is low, then we also have a low probability that that a value is mapped to itself. Finally, we chose for Duster the set of fine layers as the ith power of a bit permutation p, composed with a fixed linear layer L. And this leads to many advantages in the security analysis. And we saw on the slide before that for computing the probability of collisions for the bit permutations, we have to compute the difference of those. And the difference of bit permutations, which are a power of p, is again a power of p, so that it simplifies the analysis. And L is constructed from a BCH code so that we obtain a large branch number. And this large branch number ensures good diffusion properties and a very low probability for linear trails. The paper of this analysis are written in the paper. P has many coprime cycles, and choosing this number of cycles is a trade-off between the order of P and the probability of collisions. We implemented the keystream generation for Rasta and Duster for 80 and 120 bit security level, and the block sizes are for both ciphers the same. The block size is basically a trade-off between AND and XOR operations. The higher the block size, the less rounds we need, and the number of rounds is equal to the number of ANDs per bits. And the number of XOR operations is quadratic in the block size. So if we have a small block size, we have less XOR operations, but we need more AND operations. Duster performs about 200 to 400 times better. And that's basically because computing the bit permutation is much more efficient than evaluating the XOF plus constructing the matrix. If we look, for example, at the first version of Duster with the smallest block size of 219, there we have six rounds. That means seven fine layers. And these seven fine layers in total already consist of over 300,000 bits, which have to be computed pseudo-randomly of the XOF. And just for encrypting in the end 219 bits with the cipher. So that shows that these XOF leads to a really large overhead. But since on a normal PC, the metric that an AND operation is more expensive than an XOR operation does not hold, the comparison is not completely fair. But as mentioned in the beginning, with the example of hybrid encryption, this scenario on a normal PC is also important. But more significant is the comparison in the FHE setting. Therefore, we implemented both ciphers in the HeLib. Remember that just the application of the affine layers and the chi function have to be done under FHE, but not the evaluation of the XOF. And since FHE in general is really slow, the evaluation of the XOF is now negligible. Raster needs uniformly drawn affine layers for the security arguments, but for Duster, the security arguments are different. And this allows us to reuse some bit permutations within the generation of one keystream block. And this reuse leads to some performance improvement in the FHE evaluation, while for Raster, every affine layer is different because it's generated pseudo-randomly. And this advantage of reusing affine layers leads to 15 to 20% faster encryption in the HeLib for Duster. We see a couple of further research directions. The block sizes in Raster are chosen very conservatively, and we just took the same ones for Duster, but maybe they can be reduced by taking our improved security analysis into account. And for the linear layer, we used BCH codes, which we found most straightforward, but other code choices could also be interesting. And finally, a more structured linear layer could be considered, which could lead to better security arguments and also to performance improvements. Let's do a quick recap of what we changed from Raster to Design Duster. First, we replaced the nonce and block counter together with the XOF of Raster by just the block counter to create a deterministic approach. The affine layer is now split into two parts. First, we have the variable bit permutation determined by the block counter, and the second part of the affine layer is now a fixed linear layer. The linear layer is chosen so that the branch number is large, and the bit permutations are chosen in such a way that the probability of collisions is low. Thank you for your attention.